Good day, everybody. Hope everybody's doing okay, best as you can, for this Thursday, September 17th, 2020. My name is Jewel, and this is the Tropical Update for J7409 weather. Looking at the radar right now, this is around 9:15 this morning, we can see what is left of Sally. Here is Sally moving through now. Sally still has winds, I believe, of 30 miles per hour. We will go over to the National Hurricane Center and check all that out in just a moment. Biggest threat for Sally now, of course, as she's moving north-northeast, is rain. Looking like the biggest threat of heavy rain for North Carolina, Raleigh, Virginia Beach. You guys are going to get a lot. Charlotte. All of you guys, as you can see, this is moving through portions of Georgia, moving up into South Carolina. Wherever you see these heavier cloud tops, most of the heavy rainfall is right down in here now. One big problem with this is that it's going to cause a threat of tornadoes. So like for Charlotte, Raleigh, even eastern North Carolina, Norfolk, Virginia Beach, you guys, and this chance will be on the rise throughout today and especially tonight as Sally tries to pick up and move off the coast. Also along the Outer Banks, down in Myrtle Beach, all of these areas, the whole coastline of North Carolina and parts of Virginia. So be aware of that. We will check out more things in detail in just a moment. Now, last evening, I told everybody to watch out for this. This looks like a little of nothing, I know. And for the longest time, I didn't think it had enough to do anything. I changed my mind yesterday afternoon. I got to looking at some things, and this has a great chance of developing. It looks like nothing, and you're saying, well, why will it develop? Because of the Earth's rotation. Now you're going, okay, Jewel, you've lost it. But no, I haven't. It's called simply the Coriolis effect. Now, what all of this is, to bring it down in real simple terms, when the Earth rotates, it causes a system to spin like this one. Okay? That's what's going to happen with it. That's going to cause the Coriolis effect. Now, whenever anything is where this is located, like over warm waters, even when it was just a regular disturbance, which it is now, but when it's over the warm waters and there's moisture, and here's the key, relatively light winds aloft. When you have all of that combined and the Earth is rotating, it causes the Coriolis effect, and that's why I think Wilfred will come out of this system. Taking a quick look at the power outages for today. Before I get into that, I want to say that I am very sorry to report Sally has caused one death. One man has died because of Sally, and one woman is missing because of Sally as of now. Looking at the power outages here in Florida, we have 210,145 people without electricity. Moving up to Alabama, 282,333 people without no power. Over in Georgia, 39,553. Still trying to get back from Hurricane Laura over in Mississippi. Still have 51,663 people without electricity. And because of all of the fires over in the state of California, 14,320 people still are without electricity. As I mentioned just a few moments ago, good chance of tornadoes popping up. 5% chance in parts of Georgia, a large portion of South Carolina and North Carolina. It's 2% for northeastern North Carolina and around Norfolk and Virginia Beach as of now. But as I said, as the day progresses and nighttime falls, Sally moves a little closer over, this will increase for the Virginia area of tornadoes. We do have a 2% chance of maybe some tornadoes popping up over in Oregon. Be aware of this. If you're in any of these areas, the possibility of tornadoes are very high. Now, as we are over to the National Hurricane Center, we do have disturbance number one. I think this is going to be Wilfred. It could probably turn into Wilfred within the next 24 to 36 hours. I'm thinking it's going to be very soon, just because of the atmospheric conditions and all of the other things that go along with it that make it up. Now, the thunder storm activity, it has continued to increase and become better organized as of the morning hours, and associated with a well-defined low-pressure system located over the southwestern Gulf of Mexico. Now, the upper-level winds are gradually becoming more conducive for development. And if this recent development trend continues, a tropical depression or a tropical storm could form later today. Now, the low is expected to meander over the southwestern Gulf of Mexico for the next day or so before it moves slowly northward and northeastward Friday and Saturday. Now, an Air Force Reserve reconnaissance aircraft is scheduled to investigate the disturbance this afternoon. It's high, folks. 2 days, 5 days, 90% chance. It doesn't look like anything is going to stand in the way of this going on up and getting organized in strength. We will keep our eyes on this. It could go up like this. It could just meander around. It's a little too early to tell. You know how this goes. It might look like one thing one day and another thing the next day within 6 hours. But we'll check it out and see what it's looking like right now. Here is Sally, just Tropical Depression Sally. Still got winds of 30 miles per hour. It's located at 31.8 north, 85.7 west. It's moving northeast at 12 miles per hour. Teddy is going to become a major hurricane, folks. Right now, the winds are 105 miles per hour. It's located at 18.3 north, 52.3 west. It's moving northwest at 12 miles per hour, and it's looking like Teddy is going to affect Bermuda. Can you believe it? Bermuda's going to have effects of a hurricane within a week's time again. If this does what it looks like it may do, folks along Mississippi, Alabama, Florida Panhandle, looks like you might get some more action too. We'll have to wait and see. It could go across Florida and then up the coast, but like I say, it's too early to pinpoint it down, but this is going to form. I noticed it yesterday afternoon before the National Hurricane Center put it up, and as I did all my research and followed all the rules and regulations of what may happen and what it looks like could, it does look like it's going to happen. Now, Teddy should not affect the island areas. And then we have a disturbance number two over here. It's elongated, as you can see. It's an area of low pressure. It's a few hundred miles south-southwest of the Cabo Verde Islands. It's producing disorganized showers and thunderstorms. The environmental conditions are expected to be conducive for development during the next few days, and a tropical depression could form before upper-level winds become less favorable over the weekend. Now, this low is forecast to move west-northwestward around 10 to 15 miles per hour during the next several days. It's got a 40% chance in 2 days, 50% chance in 5 days. If it were to form, we'd be going over to the Greek alphabet, and it would be named Alpha. Vicky, not a whole lot happening. Vicky's got 40 mile per hour winds, and it's located at 29.9 north, 36.7 west, moving west-northwest around 7 miles per hour. Vicky is not going to last, folks. Now, over here we have disturbance number 3. Now, these are thunderstorms and showers. They've been a little more concentrated this morning and associated with a non-tropical area of low pressure located over the far northeastern Atlantic Ocean. It's several hundred miles east of the Azores. Now, a little bit of a development could happen, additional subtropical development. It is possible over the next day or so as it moves east-southeastward and then northeastward at about 10 miles per hour. The system is expected to reach the coast of Portugal late Friday. So it's got a 30% chance in 2 days, 30% chance in 5 days. Whatever happens, Portugal, you are going to get gusty winds, not hurricane winds. I don't mean that, but it's going to be breezy, and you are going to get some rain out of this system. As we take a look at Tropical Depression Vicky, you can see it is a depression center, and it's going to keep on weakening down to a post-tropical depression system. It should keep moving the way it is. For you guys on the islands, you might get a little bit of wind out of this. Maybe this is just a wild guess. It's not that much at all, folks. Maybe anywhere from 15, 25, maybe 30. No big deal, but you should get rain out of it for all of the island areas up in here. Here's a track for Sally. You can see Sally is a depression also, and she will turn post-tropical depression and weaken on out in a little bit here. She gets up to South Carolina later, early morning hours of Friday, tomorrow. But as you can see, I'm stressing, we're already getting rain out of this system from the Outer Banks all the way across in areas in here. We're already getting the rain. That's why, as you can see how it tracks across Charlotte, Raleigh, all of those areas, you have a great chance of much rain and a real good chance of tornadoes. But that tornado chance goes all the way from Norfolk, Virginia Beach down the entire coastline of North and South Carolina. And here we have Hurricane Teddy. It is a hurricane. By tomorrow, it should be a major hurricane. Remain that way all the way through Sunday. Now, as Sally exits the coast, that should be what nudges with the low pressure systems all up and down here, which they're very strong with Sally as she comes off the coast, a very strong low pressure system. It should nudge Teddy to the east just a little. If it was not for Sally and the low pressure coming off the coast, well, Teddy could bounce right on across, okay? But hopefully, and the way that it's continuing to look, as it has for several days now, it will make that turn starting Monday. I'm hoping Sunday it starts, but Monday. Either way, Bermuda, you guys are going to get it again. You can see Bermuda is right there. Please prepare now. I know you're still trying to clean up from Paulette, but it looks like Teddy's headed your way. So anyone in the Bermuda area, please take note and start to prepare now. If you haven't subscribed, please do so. Click subscribe, click the bell, make sure you check off all. Check that all off, because that's a YouTube thing. If you don't check that, you won't receive my videos as I put them out. Do those things and you should receive them. I'll try to keep you up to date on things that I see may be a threat coming your way. Now, here is the system right here, okay, that I've been talking about. You can see it's trying to get a little bit of circulation. Now, you can see a timestamp right here. Here, of course, is Sally as it's moving off. And one other quick thing, everybody up and down the entire eastern seaboard, Sally is going to be causing very rough rip current conditions and surf conditions once it gets off and gets around the coastline area. So take that in mind and be safe and careful. I will turn this on and just let it move through. This is the European model, as you can see. It's only one model. Don't act like this is what's going to happen. This is just a possibility of what might happen, and people need to stay aware. Now, you can see now the winds have picked up, looking like it's got circulation by tomorrow right in here. Winds at this time, well, they're probably in the 40s. We'll wait till it gets a little closer up. You see how it's moving along here. Now, when we'll have more information when the reconnaissance aircraft gets back this afternoon, we'll be able to tell a little more about what's going on with it. But this is the one I really want everybody to pay attention to. You can see it's moving up, looking like it's going to go up into maybe Texas by Sunday. But it all changes. Just watch it, folks. I wanted to end with this So you guys could be aware. It may have changed since the last time I checked it a few hours ago. Looking like now maybe riding up the coastline of Texas with the center of circulation staying right offshore at this time. We move up to Tuesday. It's just going to hang out in the Gulf, and it's going to strengthen because I want to stop this just a moment. We can see now that the winds in this have picked up greatly. 68 mile per hour wind gust. So this is a very, very high-end tropical storm on the verge of a hurricane. We'll see what happens. You know, a lot's going to happen and a lot's going to change between now and next Wednesday. But as it moves along, it begins to gain more strength, and it's looking like it's going to come over again towards Louisiana, Alabama. Now it's looking like, see, the center goes right over this little section of Louisiana, but then it hops back across the Gulf. And then you can see it moves on up through Alabama and Louisiana and then becomes entangled with another low pressure system and becomes an elongated low pressure system. And this is what I was talking about will keep Teddy away from the United States. With all of this said and done, I'll keep my eyes on things, folks. You know I will. I will keep you abreast of whatever I think may be going to happen. We'll have to wait and see about this disturbance here. But I do think Wilfred will be born pretty soon, folks. We'll have to wait and see. So, everybody have a good day, a safe day, a blessed day. Pray for everyone, thoughts and prayers for everyone in the paths of these storms and for all of the fire victims out west from Washington State, Oregon, California, Nevada, parts of New Mexico, parts of Arizona, everywhere. Keep all those folks in your thoughts and prayers too. I love you all. Thank you so much for everything you do for me, the donations, the kind comments, just watching my videos and sharing them means so much to me and helps me out so much to help keep people aware and safe. Peace, love, and kindness to each and every one of you. Thank you so much for watching.